I'm gonna run over and play around with the pyrotechnics for the podium ceremony.
What? No, you can't fool around with that. We didn't get the replacement pressure valve, so I literally duct taped everything together just now. You could fry everyone on stage if the pressure gets too high.
But Rudder asked me to test it.
If he asks, just tell him I've got it under control. Whatever you do, don't touch the setup.
Okay, gotcha.
Oh, no, buddy. You're not coming through here. Sorry.
I'm here now.
Ready to meet up with Sierra Knox over at the hotel.
Some guy jumped me. He stole my mascot outfit. Who would do that?
The race is entering its final lap, 47.
Hitman hydration boost, normally reserved for the drivers. Fix me right up!
What? No, it's for after the race. Although it did kind of look like the Tour de France, but with all the syringes and I think Sierra Knox had an appointment in there as well.
Forty-seven. The race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now. That is Sierra Knox, reckless daredevil with a violent temper. Quite the handful, as I understand it.
Sierra.
What's up?
We're not talking.
Yeah, that's not gonna work, buddy. Can't
really
let you
sorry. Just wanted to know we're here for you.
Well, unless you're a very large tequila, I don't care.
Okay, got it.
You are invading my personal space, sir.
Cannot come through here, sir. Please stop. That's it. One step at a time.
Is going to be pissed.
America's oldest rodeo. Yes, sir. We've headhunted a real superstar mascot. Make sure to get yourself
I'm
over
telling
for
you,
the show's
over. Not going to be pissed. I never asked to check up on her. Well, let's just say she's got a bad case of pain.
Nice outfit. Really brings out your eyes. Miss Knox informed me you'd be here. She asked to make sure you brought the documents. So, did you bring the documents?
I have the papers right here.
Excellent. Come on in. Have a seat or something. I'll let Miss Knox know you're here.
Yes, Miss Knox. There's a guy here wearing a mascot outfit claiming you have an appointment with him. Wouldn't give his name. Got it. I'll let him know you're en route.
Hey, flamingo guy. Miss Knox is on her way. Grab a seat somewhere. She'll be here as soon as she can.
So, it's a great outfit. Thinking it must get pretty warm in there, though.
It's insulated.
Huh. Imagine that. I guess it would have to be if you're supposed to wear it for hours and hours every day. Do you, you know, get to use it at home? For parties and things like that, I mean.
No.
Right. I have a friend who's into that sort of thing. Cosplay, assuming imaginary identities. He says it's very liberating. Takes him out of the stress of everyday life and work, you know?
Not really.
Yeah, I guess it's different when you do it for a living. How's the pay?
Sufficient.
Nice. Okay, good talk.
So, Mr. I never did catch your name.
Names are for friends.
Very well. Straight to the point and all business. Walk with me.
Where are we going?
Don't worry. What am I gonna do? Kill you in broad daylight. I just want a bit of privacy here. Not about to do sensitive business like this in front of an audience.
Good idea.
So just to get this straight, you claimed in your email to have somehow found internal reports that show Cronstadt's involvement in the Tungan Valley Massacre.
Sounds about right.
Let's be clear. You and I are having this meeting because my father doesn't need to know about this. It's just another undesired distraction. I don't care if the information is true or false. I don't care if it mentions moving money from the Nexus Project into Tungan Valley Damage Control, as you claimed in your correspondence. I do care about protecting my father, which is why you and I are now here.
I see.
Leave me alone for a few minutes, guys.
Sure thing, Miss Knox. If you need us, just call. We're right around the corner.
So here's the deal. You hand over the documents and leave, and that's the end of it. And you will do that now. So here are the two possible outcomes of this meeting. One, you will leave this place and this country for good, and that will be the end of it. Everyone lives happily ever after. Two, you don't choose option one.
Target down. Next up, Robert Knox.
Ladies and gents, we are not done yet. The exhibition is about to start, so be prepared to see the Ladies and gentlemen, the fun is not over yet. We will now kick off the exhibition race. See technology of the future at its finest. Enjoy!
got some goddamn super glue or something?
Huh?
Damn, that thing's beyond fixing.
Sometime? I know I'm not a rich man, and you probably have guys hitting on you all the time, but...
Oh, that's sweet. But I have no idea that
That is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men. This must be connected to Kronstadt.
Just returning heading over to the expo building to meet Knox for the new combat android presentation.
No,
not yet. I'm letting him stew a little. The guy's a genius, and you know what they're like. This would be lacking any discipline or respect for other people. Last time I tried to have a meeting with him, he had me sitting in a room for 4 hours before canceling. I'll head up when I feel like it. All right, I'll call you after the presentation. Speak then.
Ted Mendez, a defense funding consultant with the U.S. military, is scheduled for a private demonstration of a new Kronstadt robotics project. Sounds like a way to get up close and personal with Robert Knox, 47.
What?
Mr. Mendez, good to see you, sir. The demonstration is...
Sup?
Sir.
Hello, HR? Yes, it's Ben Wheeler down at the Bayside Center. Listen, I realize this may sound trivial, but without it, you noted this letter and off the print as we moved in. I can't work without my experience, and I have been forced to bring my own.
How are you today, sir?
Right. But...
It's right in here, Mr. Mendez.
Hey there, Ted. Good to finally see you. Guess traffic...
I'm sorry. I thought you were someone else.
Let me show you everything. I'm gonna say something provocative now, Ted. War is going out of fashion.
It's dirty. It's just plain bad PR. Nobody wants to exchange their jewelry.
Welcome. Please keep moving, sir.
How are you, sir?
Collecting pictures of celebrity entrepreneurs now, 47? What are you thinking?
What the?
Nobody wants to exchange their children and loved ones for flags and medals anymore.
Greetings,
sir. Glory is gone, Ted. But luckily, Kronstadt has a solution for that. Imagine this. Android infiltrators operating in the field, disguised and fully embedded, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Indestructible robotic operators who can infiltrate the deepest sanctuary of any adversary, striking an unseen fatal blow. A surgical tool for a blunt world. Imagine an army of them. Fully equipped android medics seeking out wounded servicemen and injured civilians, bringing them to safety or patching them up then and there. Android pilots delivering payloads deep inside enemy territory with uncanny precision and minimal collateral damage. All right, Mendez, it's very straightforward. Let me show you. I just pick any of the pictures on the desk. Then I use the scanner to upload the biometric data. And Palace will do the rest.
Target acquired. Dummy D.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually feeding it biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment in modern conflict solution, Ted.
Palace is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table and scan it just like I showed you. It's perfectly safe. Go ahead. Make my day.
Targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
No, no, Command. I don't know that either, Command. I just got here.
Hi there.